So this is an approach we would, I will try to commentate our dance. Okay, we made one dance. We're going to see this for the first time now, and so this is like kind of original reactions. So this is a version of a very beloved song, Caricias. One of the versions that I recently have discovered is of this of Marisol Martinez, Los Gentiles. It's a very nice song. It's a very nice adaptation of this famous great tango. We really love to dance this tango. And we were on the process of exploring boleros, and erecto especially. So you know, erecto is, some guys call this erecto, the linear boleo, whatever, the name is not important. So it's this dynamic movement.
No vendrás, y sin embargo te espera mi amor. Quiero olvidarte y no puedo olvidar.
It is not very appropriate for a dancing floor. It's not very appropriate for social dancing, but it has this interesting dynamic that, you know, every time we want to explore. For sure, I would never put erectos when I would dance at this song, okay? The original version, this version, any version, okay? Does not fit for me. So this is a study, this is a very interesting concept to apply movements that do not originally make sense to fit in this context of this music, but then you try just for the sake of the technique, and just to see, does it make sense to use an erecto on this song? So, let's see. See, in the beginning, I am so I cannot remove the effect that this the staccato beat has on me. Okay, so in the beginning, you see, I do this. We do this. These steps. They're very. So this, by starting, you can say that this is not an erecto environment, okay? Erectus does not live in this kind of environment, okay? But let's see. Okay, so it makes sense, okay? Because, you see, I was trying to find where there is a strong beat, so to add the boleo, especially on the ending of a phrase. And this has a very interesting ending of phrase. You see, it was the beginning of the phrase, this one, okay? It was the beat that starts the phrase. So this got completely off, because I was expecting a beat on a hard impact on the ending of the phrase, but this ending of phrase on this song is has an arpeggio, has a small plink. Small plink piano. It fits, okay? But if you think that the erecto can be on the piano plink, then okay, you can use this. So, you see, there is also this theoretical thing that when the phrase has a strong beat, the next phrase of it will be soft. This is a very basic technique that the original tango composers knew, the arrangers knew, and they used it a lot to have contrast when you dance. Okay, when they arrange the music, they make sure that the music has contrast, so you can have it strong and then soft feelings on the same song. So when I understand that this is a hard phrase. I was thinking that the whole phrase, I was thinking, where shall I put this? Where shall I put this? And then when I asked it, when I asked for it to do the boleo, it is on the plink. No erecto here, okay? No erecto here. Freddy is doing well and is adding this erecto here because I lead this. It's from the other side, this erecto, okay? But You see now, it's so subtle, okay? Because, okay, of course you can choose to listen to the beat, to the bass, to boom, boom. But the music, the melody is saying such a sad story, such a, you know? Front boleo fits better, you see? On the ending of the phrase, on the strong beats of the phrase, the front boleo makes better sense. You see again here, there was no strong, no powerful beat in the ending of the phrase. One step before. Four legs.
La soledad que me envuelve el corazón va encendiendo en mi alma el fuego de tu amor lejano.
You see clearly, you can see well, I try to think, okay, to predict the music and...
Gritando tu nombre en vano, pero no estás, y en mi cruel desolación es un fantasma el recuerdo de lo que se fue. Percibo tu sombra y mi amor te nombra pidiéndote aquella caricia de ayer.
Okay, again, this is a very typical structure of this song. You see, the end of the phrase is just fading away. So if you think that I'm going to add an erecto on the ending of the phrase, then you are totally off, like this. Okay, with electric guitar, the erecto, blum, 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 yeah, I don't know.
No vendrás, y sin embargo te espera mi amor. Quiero olvidarte y no puedo olvidar, porque sos toda mi ilusión.
So this was interesting, okay? Because this was no choreographed, okay? So we try after the soltada to add an erecto, which is quite difficult because the erecto has a certain amount of, I don't know, colcada effect, and then after the soltada.
Porque sos toda mi ilusión. Esperándote estoy, mi bien, con la fe del que ama como yo.
again. I was expecting the beat.
Del que ama como yo. Y añora de ti caricias de ayer, anhelante mi buen corazón.
Okay, that was nice because we managed to put the beatings also to use the erecto to emphasize the beat of the actual phrase.
Y añora de ti caricias de ayer, anhelante mi buen corazón.
Okay, Frin is doing a great job here because she's really amplifying. So here what we try to do is I try to pass her the melody, okay? I give her the melody to play. So she takes the chance and she's becoming the piano, okay? So you can listen the piano through her footwork. Is an interesting application of the erecto, and this is very, very difficult, okay? Because you see, Frini is using the erecto not to interpret the beat, but the crescendo of the voice of the singer, okay? So using the figures in order to interpret the melody and the vocalization is a totally different thing. Usually we'll use the figures to do something on beat. But now you can see here, when her voice goes up, she was expecting this.
No vendrás, yo esperándote estoy, mi bien, con la fe del que ama como yo y añora de ti caricias de ayer, anhelante mi buen corazón.
She could have made an erecto there, but no, she wants a low bolero.